Stop sharing. Just a minute, sir.
Om Dhanvantaraya Namaha. Om Sri Guru Basavalingaya Namaha. Good afternoon, one and all. On behalf of Sri Vijay Mahantesh Ayurved Medical College, IKAL, myself, Dr. Mukta Arali, Reader, Department of Dravyaguna, SVM, AMC, IKAL, and co-organizer of Kumara Bharana 2020 National Webinar Series on Kumara Vritti, welcomes to all respected faculties, PG scholars, and UG students of different colleges who are going to attend this webinar by Zoom and those who are going to watch the live streaming on YouTube. In this crisis of COVID-19, our college is organizing the series of webinar since last 2 to 3 months with the motto of imparting knowledge. With the blessings of His Holiness, late Sri Manipra Guru late Sri Manipra Mahanta Swamiji and Sri Manipra Guru Mahanta Swamiji, and with the kind cooperation of our management, that is Sri M.G. Patanchetta, Chairman, and Sri N.L. Kannu, Vice Chairman, Sri D.N. Devgirkar, Secretary of SVM VB Sangha IKAL, and Sri K.S. Kandikund, Chairman of SVM AMC IKAL, and Dr. N.R. Vanki, Chairman R.P. Karadi Ayurvedic Medical Hospital IKAL, and under the guidance of our principal, Dr. K.C. Das, sir, Department of Kumara Vritti, SVM AMC IKAL, brings Kumara Bharana 2020, a national webinar series on Kumara Vritti. So this webinar is solely intended to enrich the knowledge of Kumara Vritti to all its participants. We are fortunate enough to have a renowned speaker from a different institutes of India. We are looking forward for your support and active participation. So on this first day of webinar, we have Dr. Vaibhav Jaiswal, Assistant Professor, Department of Kumara Vritti, Faculty of Ayurveda, Institute of Medical Sciences, BHU, Varanasi, with us. Now I request Dr. V.P. Hiremat, Assistant Professor, Department of Kumara Vritti, SVM AMC, for introducing the guest speech. Please.
Good afternoon, one and all. Myself, Dr. Vishwaradhya Hiremat, Assistant Professor, Department of Kumara Vritti, SVM Ayurveda Medical College, IKAL. It's my pleasure to welcome you all today's first guest lecture series on national webinar series held on the Kumara Vritti Department, Kumara Bharana 2020. And I welcome you all for the same. Today, it's my pleasure to introduce our renowned guest speaker, Dr. Vaibhav Jaiswal. Sir is basically from Varanasi, and sir completed undergraduate and post-graduation from Institute of Medical Science, Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi. After completing MD, sir joined as senior resident from 2012 in the same institution. Presently, sir is working as assistant professor, Department of Kumara Vritti, Faculty of Ayurveda, Institute of Medical Science, Banaras Hindu University, since from 2015. Sir has attended many international and national seminars, conferences, and presented papers also. Also published research papers in various journals and written chapter in books. With this brief introduction, I request sir to share the knowledge and clinical experience over the today's topic. And over to you, sir.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you for the introduction.
Thank you, sir.
I'm audible, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Respected to all my teachers and dear colleagues and dear students, today we are here in the Kumar Varan seminar 2020. This is a new era, and I'm sitting in Varanasi and can discuss and can interact with you all. So in this COVID era, we have developed a new theme and a new way of learning. So I must congratulate all the organizers who have taken so much good topics so that all the UG and PG students, they get benefit. And also want to congratulate them. They have almost taken all the institute, all the good institute in from Ayurveda, from each state. And I can see the speakers, they are from different state, different institution. That is very wonderful and very painstaking process. So I congratulate all the organizers for organizing such a good seminar. Now going towards the main topic, understanding cerebral palsy in children. So why cerebral palsy? Kyun hum log start karein? We are discussing cerebral palsy. As it is not a great topic or big topic in modern medicine, but for Ayurveda, it's like a universal. Anna? In every Ayurvedic college or in every Ayurvedic institute, private practitioner, in each pediatric department of Ayurveda, we will have this cerebral palsy patients each every time of the year. So CP is very important disease for practicing, who are practicing in Ayurveda, who are studying in Ayurveda, especially in pediatric practice. So starting from that, we will approach to practical approach. Okay, I'm audible now, clearly audible to all?
Sir, audible, sir. Audible, okay. Sir.
Okay, now to a 3-year-old boy with a delayed milestone. Anna, we will start from this. You can see. A slide is moving. Okay. We can see a boy, 3-year-old, Divyansh, male. MRD number is from Rajatab near Varanasi. You can see the boy is lying down. There is a complete head lagging. What are the chief complaints? He is unable to hold neck, unable to sit, unable to stand, unable to walk, and unable to speak properly according to age. As a 3-year-old boy, but he cannot able to perform all these. Unable to hold neck, which can come around 5 months. Unable to sit, which come around 6 to 8 months. Unable to stand, which comes around 1 year. But unable to walk around 18 months, and not able to speak properly, which comes around 1 to 2 years, starting from 6 months. So these are all activities are not done by this boy. This what we take chief complaint of that child. And let me remind, this is a very painful, Anna. And I will tell you in the last slide, I called it a very painful. The past history is no history of pneumonia, meningitis, encephalitis, diarrhea, typhoid, or any illness. These illness, systemic illness are not present with him. Important is birth history. The full term appropriate gestational age baby was born from primary gravida mother, primary, through a spontaneous vaginal delivery, SVD, with a delayed cry. With a delayed cry, almost 30 minutes, as told by the parent attendance, he's almost 30 minutes after that baby cry, with a Apgar score of less than 5 at 5 minutes of age, which shows severe birth asphyxia. Baby was admitted then in an ICU on fluid and antibiotics therapy for around 6 weeks, and was on mechanical ventilator for around 6 days. So we can see there's lots of hypoxia. He was on mechanical ventilator for around 6 days. Birth weight was 2.6, which was appropriate. Perinatal history, mother has taken all drugs properly as she told us, as she has taken folic acid, calcium, and all the drugs which has been prescribed to her. There is no history of any illness or complaint during 9 month antenatal period, and both TT are covered. Important is developmental history. Mother told baby start recognizes her at 3 to 4 months of age, which is appropriate, but after she did not find any sign of development. But after that, there is no sign of development milestones. In terms of milestone, there was no sign. Child can speak monosyllable like ma ba at 12 month of age, which start at generally 6 months, but he is still at this point. Feeding history: patient was on exclusively breastfeed for around 6 months, but after 6 months weaning was not proper. The weaning, which was 6 to 12 months of age, is called critical window period for any child, not for this, for any child. So and that point there should be a proper weaning, jo hamare anaprashan kaha gaya hai. Anaprashan should be a very timely and should be a start right, hai na? If you start right at the right time, then you will get a better nourishment of that baby. And the weaning was also not very much proper, and the vaccination which she given was right. At the examination, weight was 12.6, GC was fair, conscious, pallor present, there was dextrous absent, and lymph node was not so much significant. CVS was S1, S2 was normal, heart rate was 94, respiratory rate normal, so there is no other difficulty. Respiratory rate was 24, upper abdomen normal, no organomegaly or no tenderness. These are all systemic examination, vitals are normal. Basically, going to the examination of central nervous system, deep tendon reflexes, what we call it DTR, we all know, biceps, jerk, triceps, jerk, knee, ankle, all are exaggerated. In terms, you exaggerated, hai na? When you do DTR, these are all exaggerated. Among the superficial reflexes, that is about abnormal reflex, was absent. This was not present in that baby. You know, Babinski was positive, and tone was increased in bilateral upper and lower limb. The tone was increased, that was hypertonic. CDC grading, Center of Disease Control from America, grading for motor milestones at the time of registration for holding neck, sitting and standing, which is zero grading, no holding at all, no head holding, and sitting was no sitting at all, and standing and not sitting at all. At the time of registration, it was zero grading. GMFC, gross motor fine scale grading, at the time of registration, at the fine motor scale, it was grade 1. Try to reach and hold object with crude method. When we put some object towards him, he tried to catch, but with a very crude method, you know? And the monosyllable was present, language ma, ba, ba, he can announce sometimes. And personal and social, me, he was anxiety to strangers. That means he can recognize her mother and the family members and can have anxiety for the strangers. Investigations, which were routinely investigation, CBC was done, which was not very significant. LFT, RFT was also normal. The most important, the MRI, you know, which we can see what is going on in brain. The patient MRI of brain was undertaken, which reveals abnormal cystic encephalomalacia with white matter volume loss in bilateral parieto-occipital, parieto-gonal and parieto-lundic region, in bilateral dorsal thymi, and thinning of corpus callosum and cerebral white matter. Imaging suggestive of periventricular leukomalacia, sequel to perinatal hypoxic ischemic brain injury. This is the main undergoing pathology which was been there. Periventricular leukomalacia. There's periventricular leukomalacia. What is leukomalacia? Leukomalacia means there's white matter loss. There are two matter, as you know, gray matter and white matter. When there is injury in lesions in gray matter, you get like seizures, and abnormality there. When there is a lesion in white matter, you get hypotonia, hypertonia, these type of things are present. So there is periventricular leukomalacia. Ventricles are in the like base of brain, you know, where periventricle around that there is hypoxia, you know, at the time when the insult was there, as you can see in this baby. There is hypoxic, baby had not cried for almost 30 minutes and was on oxygen and ventilator for 6 days. So there was much hypoxia there, which can lead to this. So our diagnosis was spastic quadriplegic cerebral palsy. Now we will go to what is cerebral palsy towards to the Second slide. Can you see this?
Ah, hello, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Can you see cerebral palsy definition?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. I'm not getting here from here, but okay.
Sir, it's visible, sir. Here.
It's visible, not there, sir.
Ah, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, I'm doing okay. Not clearly, no, sir.
Ah, yes, sir.
Now
yes,
we will go to the theoretical part. What is cerebral palsy? What I have told Abhi earlier is I have presented a case of cerebral palsy as the student can understand what is kind of complaint and what is there on the cerebral palsy patient. So cerebral palsy, bacha kaisa hota hai? One kind can see. So, what is the cerebral palsy? By definitions, we can describe cerebral palsy as encompassing a group of non-progressive, non-contagious motor condition that causes physical disability in human development, chiefly in the various area of body movement. So, it is non-progressive. What means non-progressive? It is not like if other progressive disorder, there will be dementia or other things in a continuous process like in DMD, but it is a non-progressive. What has done before birth is there. The pathology is above before the birth. And it is non-contagious, means not infectious, not will transmit it by from person to person. And that causes physical disability in human development. Human development chiefly in various areas of body movement. So body movement are affected, but we can get in the complaints, cannot able to sit, walk like this. Then the second definition, it is a group of disorders that present after birth, characterized by abnormal control of movement or posture. The baby or the child cannot have the normal movements or the postures is not normal. Sometimes opisthotonic, hypotonia, hypertonia and the other things are present. It is not a single disease, but a group of conditions, different body parts are involved and other associated disabilities like hearing defect, visual defects, and many others. A third definition we can tell is a sciatic encephalopathy of motor or posture due to insult to the developing brain. And in the first 2 years of life or even after birth. So it is a sciatic encephalopathy. What is the cerebral? In the cerebral palsy, cerebrum refers to cerebrum, which is the affected area of the brain, and palsy refers to disorder of movement. So cerebral palsy is referred to brain and the palsy is disorder of movement. It consists of motor handicap in which we get there is not baby able to move hand, not able to sit, not able to stand, not able to walk, and non-motor handicap which are more even serious sometimes. With non-motor handicaps, we can characterize like 55% of children with cerebral palsy have speech defect. They cannot able to express themselves. They are not able to speak properly, you know, as this call. 50% have mental retardation. Mental retardation is much prominent in there. They cannot express their feelings and they are not able to tell the things and they are not able to analyze the thing. The memory is not good. So it's not only the movement disorders, but also non-motor handicap is also very important. 50% has ocular defect. You can get squints, nystagmus, refractive problems are there. 40% have epilepsy. Many of them has seizure disorders. You can get in history, there's a seizure and they are taking medicine for seizures also. 25% have hearing defect. 20% have frequent dental caries, drooling, inability to chew. And they have many have swallowing difficulty. So, they have more of them become FTD because they are not able to swallow and they are very much chances of having aspiration also. Other associated like malocclusion, enamel defects, GER, gastroesophageal reflex, drooling of saliva, constipation, incontinence, recurrent infection and failure to thrive. This all leads to failure to thrive. which is very difficult to manage in this type of BB sometimes. The non-motor handicap may be more important than the motor ones sometimes. So William John Little, he was the one who coined the term first time he noticed in children about the cerebral palsy. What are the risk factors? Anna, we must know what are the risk factors, how we can say this baby can go into cerebral palsy. So prematurity and low birth weight are the two most important risk factors for CP universally. Means prematurity, baby born before 34 weeks or those who are born before 28 weeks, they are very much liable to having CP. And low birth weight, it is less than 2.5, but if it is less than 1000 gram, that they are very, many much prone for going into CP. Because the periventricle veins present there in the time of birth, they are so much fragile, then even slight change in BP can burst and lead to IVH. So there was research in going a collaborative perinatal project in which 45,000 children were regularly monitored from in utero to age of 7. And they have got to the result that most children with CP born at term with uncomplicated labor and deliveries. Means ki most of the children, they do not have any like birth asphyxia at the time of birth or any complication at the time of birth. In 80% cases, features were identified to antenatal factors causing abnormal brain development. So it is before birth. 80% cases are before birth. What are the causes are present are before birth. A substantial number of children with CP had congenital anomaly external to the central nervous system. Many of the anomalies, tumors or other which infections, torch infections, they are all present after the central nervous system. Fewer than 10% of children with CP had intrapartum asphyxia. As this, in this child, it is intrapartum asphyxia is present. Intrauterine exposure to maternal infections like chorioamnionitis, inflammation of placental membrane, umbilical cord inflammation, foul smelling amniotic fluid, maternal sepsis, temperature above 38 during labor, urinary tract infection is associated with increased risk of CP in normal birth weight infants also. Now, if these are present with this, they have more chances of having CP in children with normal birth weight also. So what are the incidence? Incidence is almost 2% to 2.5% in 1000 live birth. It's not much common nowadays, but we get still children of CP here because the government has much progress. All the deliveries should be in the hospitals under trained person, but we still have CP patients. Prevalence of CP is increased among low birth weight, particularly those weighing less than 1000 gram, primarily because of intercerebral hemorrhage and periventricular leukomalacia, as I have told. What are the classification? We can classify CP in many ways, and some other like etiology, we can go for perinatal, natal, and postnatal. The most important topographical, how we can see monoplegia, means only one limb is affected, paraplegia, basically the lower limb, both lower limbs, triplegia, one both lower limb, one upper limb, quadriplegia, which is very common, all four limbs are involved, diplegia, mostly the lower limb, even the upper limbs can be involved, and hemiplegia, half of the body, and double hemiplegia means whole of the body, including one more affected than the other. And on the physiological basis, we have spastic cerebral palsy, hypotonic cerebral palsy, extrapyramidal, and sometimes mixed also. We can say all the features are sometimes present in many of the babies. And the functional in class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4, with no limitation to physical activity, to mild, moderate, to severe, and no use of physical activity. So this table shows the motor syndrome and what are the pathology behind it and what can be the major causes. You can see in spastic diplegia, spastic means where the tone is increased. Diplegia means basically the involvement of upper limb or the both lower limb, in which the neuropathy in the brain, what we get in MRI or CT, is periventricular leukomalacia. There is volume loss. and the major causes are like prematurity, ischemia, infection, and sometimes endocrine like hypoglycemia and hypothyroidism can be there. In the spastic quadriplegia, there is PVL again, then multicystic encephalomalacia, ischemia can be an infection are the other major causes. And sometimes genetic causes are also, and chromosomals are preferred. Hemiplegia, strokes in utero or neonatal. Sometimes when the baby are admitted due to some other causes, but there is a stroke like CVA or some embolism was there, which goes to the brain at some part and can cause this hemiplegic baby. Thrombophobic disorders, infections, in case of septicemia, genetic, developmental. Extrapyramidal athetoid or dyskinetic CP means extrapyramidal, which is outside the brain. This main cortex, your cerebral palsy, your cerebral ke bahar ki baat karein, in which mainly the putamen, globus pallidus, basal ganglia is involved. And the major causes are asphyxia, Kernicterus is bilirubin encephalopathy. Normally, all the children have physiological bilirubinemia, but when it increases and goes to in above the pathological line and passes the blood-brain barrier and causes damage to the brain by increased bilirubin level, basically the unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia, so then leads to extrapyramidal CP. What are the etiological causes we can know? Cerebral palsy is caused by damage to the motor control center of the developing brain and can occur during pregnancy, during childbirth or after birth. As I've told, perinatal causes are more important, which are at least 70%, natal are only 10%, and postnatal like meningitis and other are 20%. Prenatal causes, basically metabolic, may hypoglycemia if the mother has uncontrolled diabetes and others. Intrauterine infections like TORCH, toxoplasma, rubella, cytomegaly, herpes, brain malformation and infarction, if there is some malformation in the brain, corpus callosum or other, which can also lead to this as if there is SOL. Toxins, teratogenic drugs, any radiations, there are many drugs, sometimes mother takes unknowingly or knowingly some drugs which are teratogenic, can also lead to damage to the brain. So it's very important. In India, we can get drugs at any medical store. The kisi ko dard hua at any time when they are not knowing they are pregnant, or even they are knowing they are pregnant, they can easily get drugs from medical store without any prescription, and they take some drugs which can lead to this teratogenic effect. There are chromosomal anomalies, genetic syndromes. Down syndrome is mainly sometimes associated with this. RH incompatibility, maternal disease during pregnancy. These are all related to the prenatal causes. And the natal causes like infection, due to infection in urinary tract or others, if there is systemic illness. Asphyxia and prematurity are the very important causes in case of natal. And the postnatal like meningitis, traumatic brain injury or any toxin. Sometimes can also septicemia, severe septicemia in which there is damage to the brain, which can lead to this CP. Then what are the clinical presentation? How would you know ki, how will you assess early ki, is this baby of CP? So the lack of muscle coordination when performing voluntary actions, and at the mother or the attendant will say the baby is not able to getting the normal milestones as normally in 6 months of baby, the baby can hold the neck, he can immaturely pencil grab start, or in the 2 year baby or 3 year baby who can do normal activities, but they are not doing the as normal as other child in the society. Stiff or tight muscle or aggregated reflexes, spasticity. Spasticity is almost 60-70% in all CP patients. There is a hypertoning. The tone is so much high that this we cannot bend the child. Walking in toe or foot or leg dragging. They are not able to properly walk if they are walking. So the walking is not only mostly proper. Walking on toe. Crouching gait or scissoring is always present in many when the spastic is there, you can get scissoring at the ankle level or at the knee level also. Muscle tone can be as told, hypertonia or hypotonia can be there. Seizures are very common in all form and required therapy. Seizure, many times as in my practice of almost 10 years from MD, many times patients escape or they hide this complaint of CP if in seizure. When we ask seizure is there or they are taking medicine, many times the patient says ki nahi sir aisa nahi hota, but when they are admitted here in our wards for treatment of CP for panchkarma and we get encountered seizure, so when we ask them to sir aata tha kabhi pehle hum log dawai chalaye the ab chala rahe nahi chala rahe hain, so these are very common problems which are present. You can see the topographical presentation, monoplegia, paraplegia, hemiplegia, triplegia, we can see with the colors. So first, coming to the spastic cerebral palsy, the most common type overall cerebral palsy occurring in 70 to 80% of all cases. So this is the most common type. When you go to your ward or when in your OPD, when cerebral palsy children come, you will get most of the time with the spastic cerebral palsy. Hypotonia and extra pyramidal are very less encountered, but the spasticity are more. So in this hemiplegia means half, 25% are mentally retarded. The mental retardation was there. May have seizure disorders. We can get seizures at the time of 2 years or even less. Etiology generally are intertwined thromboembolism. What we have told in maybe in time of birth or after birth, there is some embolism going on, which in fact the some artery which leads to hemiplegia. The baby can recognize after 4 to 6 months when they are not developing the milestones properly. Abnormal persistent fisting. Fisting means it will be like this. Apna hath angutha jo hai andar kya rahega. You can see it is normally present to 2 to 3 months, but it will be persistent fisting. There will be there. Abnormal posture or gait disturbance may be presenting complaint. The patient will complain of the baby is not able to getting the normal milestone. He is not able to sit. Is not able to hold the neck or like this. Or even if they are baby coming with 2 or 3 years, they will say they are not able to stand properly. So the pathology revealed by CT scan we can get or MRI, atrophy of cerebral hemisphere on contralateral side. After deciduation hota hai, jo crossover hota hai. So if we get clinically present at left side, then there will be mostly jo uska presentation, jo pathology hogi, then will be on the right side. The contralateral side will be affected. The lateral ventricles on contralateral to other side of the affected extremities. The clinical feature, one side more affected, spastic or weak, and upper limbs are more affected than the lower limb. Decreased spontaneous movement on the affected side, matlab jo spontaneous movement on the affected side jo hoga wo decrease hoga. Early hand preference on normal side, jo normal side hai usko jaldi wo prefer karega koi kaam karne mein. When we hold kisi ko cheez ko pakadne ko, to the baby will try to hold from the normal side rather than getting the other side. There will be delayed walking and abnormal gait circumflexion. Wo apna ek pair जिस पैर नॉर्मल होगा उसको तो ठीक से रखेगा, अदरवाइज द अफेक्टेड लिम्स को वो पूरा सर्कमडक्शन घुमा-घुमा के चलेगा. देयर विल बी डिस्टोनिया, पोस्चर ऑफ अपर लिम इज रनिंग, और इक्विनोनस डिफॉर्मिटीज ऑन द लोअर लिम, इंक्रीज जीटीआर, पॉजिटिव बेबिंस्की साइन एंड द अपर लिम एडक्शन एट द शोल्डर, फ्लेक्शन एट एल्बो एंड द रिस्ट जॉइंट, एंड देन लोअर लिम यू कैन गेट एडक्शन ऑफ हिप एंड एक्सटेंशन एट नी एंड एंकल जॉइंट. यू कैन दिस पोस्चर when the baby lies. Then the quadriparesis, jo agar ye hemiplegia tha, then the spastic quadriparesis, this is the most severe form of CP. Matlab all the four limbs are involved in this, hai na, the most common in term babies, hai na, this is more common in terms baby, and when we talk of hemiplegia, they are more common in preterm baby. IQ in this severe mental retardation. On the mental retardation, which was more in case of hemiplegia, इसमें एकदम और damage रहता है brain, So there is severe mental retardation. Seizures are frequent, not as much as hemiplegic. And the clinical features like severe spastic of all limbs, the hypertone, the tone is increased in all the four limbs. Sign of upper motor neuron lesions is there. We can get DTR increase and all others. Flexion, contraction of knee and elbow by late childhood. Increased tone brisk reflexes. Plantar extensor response and have a posterior tonus position. वो धनुर बाद जो पूछा पूरा आपने आपको बच्चा पीछे की ओर खींचता है बार बार और वो posterior tonus position. Feeding and swallowing difficulty. It's very difficult to feed these kind of baby. They are very much in difficulty in this. Primitive reflexes are present. Speech impairment. They are not able to speak properly. Jaw movement is not present. And many times there are many other deformity there. Restricted voluntary movement. Voluntary movement. They cannot perform. They cannot drink by themselves. They cannot eat by themselves. And there are all other medical defects like non-motor handicaps, which is present also with them. The pathology behind that we can get in MRI, severe periventricular leukomalacia, PVL, and multicystic cortical encephalomalacia. The cortex is also very much involved. And then comes to diplegia, and a common in preterm baby. And IQ is generally better. In this kind of baby, the IQ is almost there, and the seizures are very less frequent. And etiology is common is prematurity. So these are better babies than this hemiplegic and this quadriplegic babies. The clinical features prominently spasticity in lower limb. Basically, the lower limbs are more involved, and the sign of upper motor neuron lesion are there. And difficulty in application of diapers because the lower limbs are involved, so there is incontinence and other features are also present. The first indication of spastic diplegia is often noted when affected infant begins to crawl. जब वो crawling करना चलता है 9-10 महीने पर जब हम लोग कहते हैं crawling आ रही है 9-10 महीने पे, then we can see the these features are present. They are not able to get their limbs as toned as in normal babies. The child uses arm in the normal reciprocal fashion but tends to drag leg behind more as a rudder. वो commando crawl जो दिखाता है कि वो लोग चलते हैं अपने हाथ से knee से चलते हैं. तो उस तरह से बच्चा अपने आप को शुरुआत करता है. नॉर्मली और बच्चे होते हैं, दे कैन टेक इट देयर हैंड एंड लेग्स बोथ बाय द बाय साइड. मेंटेन सीजरिंग ऑफ लोअर लिम्ब व्हेन सस्पेंडेड फ्रॉम एक्सिला. जब हम लोग एक्सिला से बच्चे किसी को उठाते हैं तो वो सीजरिंग आती है. वॉकिंग टो टिप टो डिसयूज एट्रोपी ऑफ लोअर लिम्ब एंड हैव लोअर लिम्ब्स आर मोर सीवियरली अफेक्टेड विद एक्सटेंशन एंड एडक्शन पोस्टरिंग and brisk tendon reflexes. Pathology behind this is periventricular leukomalacia, as we can get in most of the baby, particularly in the area where fibers intervening the legs through course through the internal capsule. जहाँ पर वो internal capsule से pass करता है, तो generally वहीं पर pathology होती है. Severe spastic diplegia is characterized by disused atrophy and impaired growth of the lower extremities. And by disproportionate growth with the normal development of the upper limb. And if there is paraplegial muscle involvement, the child may be unable to sit. कई बार जो lower limb के साथ साथ there is involvement of spine also at the sacrum level, then the baby is also not able to sit. So it becomes very more difficult in that baby. But the hands are generally normal. And then the second time is extrapyramidal cerebral palsy. Also called ethetoid or choreoethetoid CP. Extrapyramidal means the cortex se hat gaya hai. Their lesion dyskinetic CP accounts for approximately 10 to 20% of the CP. Clinical manifestation include dyskinesis such as ethetoid. Ethetoid means involuntary movements. बच्चों में involuntary material focal movement होता रहेगा. Choreiform movement, वो involuntary हाथ का movement, पैर का movement होगा. Dystonia. The tone may be sometimes hypertonic, sometimes hypertonic. It will fluctuate in this. There are tremors and rigidity. The etiology generally is hyperbilirubinemia or more severe anoxia that leads to causes basal ganglia dysfunction. So the function of basal ganglia, you know, basal ganglia is like a tuner. जैसे आप radio चलाते हो, when you tune radio, when it gets in good frequency, तब उसकी आवाज अच्छे से आती है. So its basal ganglia is like a tuner in our body for the motor functions. So the basal ganglia is affected, so the all the voluntary functions of the body get disturbed. You know? So in this extrapyramidal cerebral palsy, basically the tone or basically the basal ganglia is involved. So the all the voluntary movements get affected, and the mental and sensorineural hearing dysfunction may be present. These are also present. I will tell you. Less common in spastic. This is less common than spastic cerebral palsy. It is only 10% or less. Affected infants are characterized by hypotonia with poor head control, marked head lag, and development and develop increased variable tone with rigidity and dystonia over the several years. As I have told, you, sometimes hypertonia we can get, and when they get try to do something, they get hypertonia. Otherwise, then much time hypotonia is present. Feeding difficulty is there. Tongue prostitution, tongue generally bahar kahi baar rehti hai. Drooling rehti hai. Drooling is much present in many babies. And that leads to difficulty in feeding. Unke their clothing mein problem aati hai. There are many times patient wo kehte hai itni zyada drooling hoti hai ki pura kapde kharab ho jate hain. So there are many problems which are also present with that also. Speech defect, this there, speech may be present or sentence are slurred and the voice modulation is impaired. It's generally upper motor neuron lesion signs are not present, seizures are I was disconnected. Okay, again start karte hain. So in this extrapyramidal CP we get in MRI shows lesion with global pallidae. Bilateral extrapyramidal CP can also be associated with lesion in basal ganglia and thalamus. So there lesion in basically in the basal ganglia and thalamus, these are involved in this extrapyramidal CP. And the third one is hypotonic or atonic cerebral palsy, which is also less common than these. The Babinski response is positive. Dentin reflexes are normal or brisk. This can be normal or brisk can be there, or sometimes not present. Often severely mentally retarded. These kind of patients are very not able to responsive. The cortex has been damaged much, and there is much severe mental retardation is present in. Cerebral involvement occurs in the is less. 1 minute. Occur in less than 5% of the patient. There is hypotonia and hyporeflexia. The reflexes are diminished. In DDR, you get decreased DDR. Anataxia and inattention tremors appear by the age of 2 years. Mental status may be near normal in some patients. So, and the last term is mixed type. Many children of CP have mixed involvement in which ataxia and dystonia occurs together with spasticity. This is the last type in which we get both, all the type of involvement is there. It may be due to many times when there is severe anoxia present at a time of birth, and there is prenatal involvement also. So we can get mixed type of CP, which are more very have bad prognosis. So we go to diagnosis. What we need to do, diagnosis is many clinical investigations are there. Cerebral palsy remains a clinical diagnosis. The essential finding includes delayed motor milestone, abnormal muscle tone, hyporeflexia. So in these type of patient, we don't have to do much of the blood investigations or other, but the diagnosis is basically made by our clinical history taking, and the patient sometimes comes in our Ayurvedic OPDs with more they much file and much when they come from big centers or from modern hospitals after making the big, big diagnosis, they return to our Ayurvedic sometime hospital so that they can get something good from out of that. So, but that, most of the time diagnosis remains to be clinical. Without take, when we take history, we will know everything. So history is the most important part of for any diagnosis for, or for any diseases, you know. So delayed milestones, when a milestone history is very important in each and every baby. When you see normal babies also, we ask to every child in our OPDs, when he developed, start holding his neck, when rolls overcome, when he starts, he or she starts sitting without support, with support, standing, when she or he starts speaking. So milestone history should be properly taken. If it is beyond the red flag, beyond the time of all, even if the baby is not able to move head after 6 or 7 months of age, if not able to walk or stand beyond the 18 month of age, then there should be looked out. Sometimes patient escapes, unko lagta hai ki bhi dheere dheere chalega, hamare yahan late chala hai. But if you find this condition, so we have to indicate and we can go for investigations also. So abnormal muscle tone, sometimes flappy baby are there, and sometimes hypertonia, which was present. Hyperreflexia, when we do DTR, we will get. The diagnosis of CP has historical rested on the patient history and physical examination. CP should be suspected if child with LBW, perinatal insult and increased tone, feeding difficulties, does not keep pace with the anticipated normal range of neurological and behavior development. So if it is LBW and there is hypoxia at birth, we can suspect and we can go through that diagnosis and we can go for that history. Record abnormalities of tone, posture, involuntary movement and neurological deficit should be recorded. These all should be recorded. The MRI of the brain is currently the evaluation of choice for the vast majority of children. So if MRI is present in your premises or nearby, we should go for MRI. Otherwise CT scan also there, but the best part is ki if you have MRI. So we'll show abnormality in about 90% of the cases. There may be included major or minor brain malfunction, in utero strokes and wide method abnormalities. As we can go at PVL and others. CT scan is also capable to reveal tertication conditions as hydrocephalus, pons cephaly, arteriovenous abnormalities, subdural hematoma and hemangioma. EEG is indicated in CP patient associated with seizure. We go for EEG, it's more important. Other complications like deformation, hip dislocation, kyphosis, scoliosis, constipation, UTI, weakness, clonus, seizures are these present. So now moving towards management part, you know. So what are the management that become the most important for us and for any, because sometimes these children become liability on society and also on parents. You know, they are, most of the time parents are so much disturbed, the whole family get disturbed with this kind of parents. But the most the time mothers is the most sufferer, you know, because mother doesn't or the father doesn't let his child and the whole the family is not so much cooperating many times. So the management part is mainly remains ki what can we do best for the baby. We cannot say the, it's not like diarrhea or other infection ki it will go on and it will get out, ye theek ho jayega. But most of the patient in our setups or in other part of country or in anywhere, the exact we cannot get the treatment part is for any child. Sometimes we get a good result in some patient, but not in all patients. So what are the treatment modalities which are present from modern point of view and from Ayurvedic? Because patient come to us for Ayurvedic treatment for this kind of patient, and we have almost all the years we have this kind of patient waiting and in OPDs also. So treatment of cerebral palsy is a lifelong multiple dimensional process. Focus on the maintenance of associated conditions. The ultimate goal is to minimizing disabilities while promoting independence and full participation in society. Promoting independence is the main aim. The baby can do certain duties by himself. He can perform, whether he can go for toilet, he can wear his clothes, he can eat well. At least this can be done. That will become a big thing for that child. You know? So promoting independence. All treatment efforts are directed to gain independence in activities of daily living, ability to go to school and have social life. Beyond that, but in some children it's possible in which IQ is intact and certain IQ is there and have a social life. The treatment strategy is based on the realistic evolution of child, present functional status and possible future prognosis. What is the present, how much damage is there, how much milestones are delayed, at what time the patient are coming, if they are coming at early, less than 2 years, when the brain development chances are there, then there are much chances of having, we can go through this. Important point of history, what we should ask all the parents when we are taking history, you know. So pregnancy, premature, bacha is the, was term baby, preterm baby or postterm baby. If they're preterm, we must assess maternal disease, uncontrolled diabetes, maternal hypertension if there's what present. Delivery emergency, agar there's delivery with the emergency, LSCS hua tha, ki elective tha, SVD tha, so we should ask this thing. Prolonged rupture of membrane to nahi tha, prolonged first or second stage to nahi tha. इसी तरह आफ्टर बर्थ प्री मैच्योरिटी साइन और स्मॉल साइज बेबी तो ना एसजीए तो नहीं था डिलेड और वीक आई तो नहीं थी डिलेड पुअर सकिंग जो सकिंग रिफ्लेक्स वाज देयर और नॉट और देयर बेबी वाज एडमिटेड इज देयर हिस्ट्री ऑफ हाइपरबिलिरुबिनिया आफ्टर बर्थ न्यूनेटल सीजर वाज इज प्रेजेंट और आरडीएस मींस रेस्पिरेटरी डिस्टर्बेंस वाज देयर सो दिस ऑल शुड बी आस्क्ड यू नो टू एवरी पेशेंट हु आर कमिंग टू योर फॉर सर्वाइवल पेशेंट. So what are the goal of management? How we can provide? They improve preserve function. Those functions are, sometimes the baby are able to sit, right? And so we have to preserve at least that function and we have to promote others. And a development of, develop compensatory function, encourage independence, maintain normal growth, facilitate communication, ensure good dental and other hygiene and rehabilitations. So rehabilitations, they are many departments which can get together for this kind of baby. You know, it's not part of only an Ayurvedic physician can do. It's part of many other have to come together for treatment modalities of this kind of baby. Then we can get the best outcome. You know, then pediatric neurologists, psychotherapy, occupational therapists, orthopedic surgeon, neurosurgeon, speech therapist, social worker, nutritionist. All should come together, even the social worker, they have big role in this kind of patients. Treatment may include one or more of the following: physical therapy, and occupational therapy, speech and learning therapies. There are certain medications, I will not go in this more detail, but anticonvulsant, if their seizure are present, then we can give these anticonvulsant. Antispastic drug, baclofen, retroin sodium are being given. Anti-reflux drug, metoclopramide, in which there is so much of GER. Anti-constipation and antibiotics when needed. Tranquilizers for behavior problems sometimes given. Intrathecal baclofen, as I've told, is given. Hyperbaric oxygen, these are therapy non being added. Bantulin oxygen to reduce the muscle tone. Sometimes there is so much spasticity, it can be given. So baby coming to you, we must have a Barrett test for all baby. Sometimes they are able to hear with normal aid, you know. So we can, for all the baby, we must go for this Barrett or hearing test so that we can know if the baby has hearing problem, it can be solved if there is no sensory hearing loss severe, you know. So we can get this through. So all baby should go through this hearing care. Then visual, many of the patient has visual problem, right? And we don't know because child is not able to see, because he's not able to speak also. But we must go for all babies should be go through visual acuity test, right? maybe the only the specs can leads to they can see the world, you know. So all the babies we are taking for care should go for visual care also. Like that dental care, maybe the, we have to tell all these things to all the patient. Physiotherapy remains the main in case of modern medicine. They're there for physiotherapy. All the patient coming from modern hospital, they're told ki physiotherapy, wahan sir bata diye ki sir, iska sir lifelong physiotherapy karaiye aur kuch nahi hoga. Most of the patient or even all the patient coming from that their hospital who are not coming for the first time to us, from if they are referred from modern hospital, they told ki sir, they have told ki sir physiotherapy kijiye aur kuch nahi hoga, iska kuch nahi hoga. So if surgical procedure sometimes needed in case of contractures and others. Social economical support, many of the patient who are cerebral palsy patient, they are from low socioeconomic status, and they are not able to even get the normal feed to the baby, and even the treatment which is required, they are not so much economically sound. What the prevention then comes to prevention. What can be prevented? Prevention of the maternal infection, fetal or perinatal insult, good maternal care, freedom from postnatal damage reduces the prevalence. So always to get the prevention. You know, if we have good antenatal care, if we is like a pregnancy by choice, not by chance. You know, if we know this, you know, we must educate each and every couple after marriage. You know, it should be a part of marriage. Each parent or each couple should be given education to prepare for pregnancy, before pregnancy. So we can have less chances of having this kind of CP patient in our society. So prevention of this, if there is maternal infection or if there is some systemic illness, we must care of that. If there is mother having diabetes, so she must take good hyper drug so that the diabetic get under control. Hypertension is there. So all the drugs should be given at the proper time so that this can be prevented. Early diagnosis, prompt educate management plan can reduce the residual neurological and psychological emotional handicap for the child and his family. Then comes to Ayurvedic, how can we correlate this cerebral palsy to Ayurveda, and how can we translate them to also. Then an exact Ayurvedic correlation to cerebral palsy is not directly available in Ayurvedic classical literature. Different aspects of this condition can be found scattered in various contexts of antenatal, natal and postnatal care. See, science is basically a change process. What we are doing today will be a past in next 50 years. Jo aaj humko lag raha hai ki we are doing very good job, and we are doing laparoscopic surgery, or those who are doing high robotic surgery, so that will become very cheap in next 50 years. Those people, when we they see ki what is going on after 50 years, they will say ki ye kuch nahi tha, ye log kya kar rahe the. So isi tarah jo upper Ayurvedic science, which is almost 2000 years back or even more, so they have not written the exact the terminology, but they know all the disease well, hai na. They have told about the early sign and what kind of the possibilities, and jo uske clinical correlation, as there are no instrumentation and the machinery was present, but with the clinical experience they have told each and every aspect, and with their knowledge how this disease can was happening. So however, considering the classification of these respective features, CP can be compared with Vat Vyadhi or Shiro Marmar Vigat Vat Vikar, which may manifest in any of the following form: Pakshaghat, Ekangvat, Pangu, Sarvang Rog. In some of the way, Vat Vyadhi may appear at any age. See, we have three different doshas which are considered for our bodies: Vat, Pit, Kapha, and Vat remain the most important. So this is considered to be a Vat Vyadhi, hai na? तो वात इज विशिएटेड, वात दोष के कारण इस व्याधि का होता है. तो इट अगर वात का जो मतलब शिरो मर्माभिघात, जो शिर मर्म है, जो हमारा एक मेन मर्म कहला रहा है, उसमें वात विकार हो जाने के कारण अगर कोई बॉडी में डिस्टर्बेंस आ रहा है जिसके कारण इस तरह के फॉलोइंग जो क्लिनिकल मैनिफेस्टेशन दिखाई जाता है जिसको पक्षाघात हम लोग पेरिप्लेजिया पैराप्लेजिया हेमिप्लेजिया में कह सकते हैं, एकांग रोग मोनोप्लेजिया पांडु पंगु मतलब वो बच्चा नहीं चल पा रहा है, सर्वांग रोग क्वाड्रिप्लेजिया एंड मेनी अदर्स। तो दीज हैव बीन डिस्क्राइब बाय आवर आचार्यस इन देयर फॉर्म इन इन वेरी अर्ली ऑलमोस्ट सो मच ईयर बैक। तो व्हाट आर द निदान जिसको निदान बताया गया है कि आदि बल प्रवृत्त द बिफोर द बर्थ ऑफ द बेबी है ना, तो दे नो कि देयर वाज सम आवर आचार्यस नोइंग कि देयर सम प्रॉब्लम इन द स्पर्म एंड द ओवम व्हिच लीड्स टू दिस काइंड ऑफ डिफॉर्मिटी। तो दे हैव टोल्ड कपल हैविंग ग्रॉसरी डिटेक्टेबल विशेषण ऑफ शुक्र और आर्तव है ना, अकॉर्डिंग टू भाव प्रकाश स्पर्म विशिएटेड विद वात वात दृष्टि के कारण दे आर मोर प्रोन फॉर विकृति कुब्ज कुनी पंगु मूक मिनिमान स्पीच डिफेक्ट दिस चाइल्ड ऑफ चाइल्ड कैन बी प्रेजेंट इफ द स्पर्म इज विशिएटेड विद वात। सो दे आर नोइंग दिस ऑल दिस दे हैव नो इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन बट दे हैव knowing ki the if the vat has done damage to our sperm then this can leads to this type of deformities. Lady having gynecological problem yoni dosh agar yoni dosh jo hamare yahan jo bataye gaye hain they can also leads to certain kind of deformity in child having birth taking birth. Second is done bal pravit at the time of birth vat vitiated during the time of fertilization resulting in twin pregnancy. As we can say, twin pregnancy is sometimes also very complicated, which can lead to certain deformities in the child who is born. Dosh bal pravit, improper care of umbilical cord, causing umbilical sepsis, septicemia, non-observance of protective measure, जो हमारे रक्षा कर्म बताए गए हैं, अगर उसको नहीं follow किया गया जी आज के ही परिप्रेक्ष्य में present, अगर we talk of present era. If the baby is being left and not being cared properly, he can go easily into hypothermia, leading to hypoglycemia and then septicemia. And if there is umbilical care is not properly done, then it will all leads to septicemia, which leads to brain damage. So these are all present. Sanghat bal pravit nidan birth injuries and still today birth injuries are there and sometimes complicated. Birth process which can lead to this birth injuries occurring at complication of malposition, presentation, mool garbh, hypoxemic insult are also present sometimes in case of breech deliveries can be there. And then the daya bal pravit nidan, infectious disease that is graha rog affecting the majja dhatu of the body. Majja dhatu can be related to many things hai na, to daya bal ya graha rog jisko kahenge these are non been specified which can be today can be correlated with bacterial virus or others you know, so we can get in torch infection, cytomegaly, herpes and other infections, rubella. These are all sometimes leads to severe brain damage you know, so these are like graha rog. So garbhapurna nidan leads to continuation of familial disorder like उन्माद अपस्माद resulting in interpretation of normal growth and development of child. These all infections disease non-infectious disease leads to brain damage which can lead to development of child to CP. बीज दुष्टि जिसको हम sperm of worm if they get disturbed considered to one of the causes of teratological abnormality if the बीज भाग which is responsible for the formation of mustulum is vitiated it may result in defect in the mustulum of the fetus means ki agar mustulum what we consider as a brain if wahi par agar beech mein hi dikkat hai it can lead to development of brain if the development of brain is not proper then it will certainly leads to the development of child with CP. Ashya dushti dushti of chetra garbhashya may leads to deformity of child. Improper garbhani paricharya jo garbhani paricharya hamare yahan ayurved mein bataya gaya that is so much scientific if it is been properly followed then no disease or nothing will happen to a child and mother too if they are following properly. And then abhigat dhupan if this are not done properly then it all leads to certain deformities in brain. Then what are the samprapti jo hamare samprapti jaise hum modern mein bhi go form etiology then to hamari samprapti kya hai to we must know this ki how these are, how those are vitiated and what those are being considered and what is going on. Improper garbhani paricharya works either by precipitating the maternal systemic diseases or favoring the attack of infection disease or by increasing the chance of pregnancy complication. Both injuries, traumatic head injuries and hypoxic insult during the labor process may damage the mastulum by the way of shiromarmabhidak. So if these are all present causative factors, this will lead to damage to the brain leading to shiromarmabhidak. Prematurity should be considered as a complication of improper antenatal care. See, all babies are meant to get at 39 weeks. No, means term baby should be there. And if any preterm delivery should be considered by complication, you know. So if it is a premature delivery, then it is maybe due to improper antenatal care. It is seen in often in ladies indulging in diet and regimen and contraindicated for pregnancy. जो अगर गर्भोत्पाद कर भाव को अगर लिए हैं, गर्भोत्पाद कर भाव का पालन कर रहे हैं, तो ये चीजें हो सकती हैं. Then what are the samprapti ghatak? Dosh is vaat pradhan tridosh. Tino dosh ko lete hain, lekin usme vaat pradhan rahega. Dush are ras, rakt, mans, majja and shukra. Shrotas are mano va shrotas. Wo mainly involve karta hai, even pran va shrotas. Adhishtan is shira. Basically, jo brain hai, developing brain. Vyakt sthan is sarva sharir. Kyunki ye pure sharir pe hi padta hai. Dushti prakar is sang hai. And vyadhi swabhav is chirkali, long term, so even full life is involved. And then the sadhya sadhya yap and asadhya. So what are the lakshan which we get is moha, deep consciousness, jwar, sometimes fever, ruja, hypersensitivity to pain, some like cry or no cry, decreased unstable dhatus, and a dime like appearance, what described in astang sangra. Ye is tarah ka lakshan ko bataya gaya hai. Depending upon the severity of those dusha samushna, clinical presentation may vary from pangutva, diplegia, kubjatva, kyphosis, ekangvat, monoplasia, pakshaghat, hemiplegia, sarvangvat, quadriplegia, ekangvat, maybe akshepak, sorry, means convulsion, involuntary shakings, ethetoid, what CP, ardhit facial palsy, may be all associated with this. So what are the common association what we have getting in Ayurveda also? Mukhatva aphasia, the baby will not able to speak and the proper speech is not there. Vaksang dysarthria, lying speech. Bhairatva, sunne mein usko dikkat hai. There will be sensory neuro hearing loss. Anakshat chitta, behavior disorder. Apasma, seizure, and khanjatva, lameness are there. So we can see each and everything has been described in Ayurveda. You know, in their terminology, they have described each and everything. They are knowing this disease in some other or certain way condition, but the whole disease was present sometime at that time also. So now coming to best part is chikitsa. How we can treat the baby? What are the best management? What we can best outcome from our Ayurvedic medicine? So that the patient who are coming to our OPD, they have very much hope in their eyes. You know, the patient attend, the mother, the father, they come with big hope so that they know that there are some Ayurvedic drugs which can cure the baby. Although it's very, very difficult to cure a baby like that. You know, and sometimes we get a certain amount of good result, but many times in some patient, more than some patient, there's no good result, and even in some patients there is no result if they are coming very late. So the cerebral palsy may not be fully cured. The Ayurvedic treatment may be definitely help to reduce disability and improve the functioning of the affected individual to great extent. Two major preventive and specific preventive, as I have told also, before conception avoidance, consanguineous marriages, congenital abnormalities should be minimized. Jo agar consanguineous marriages nahi honge to congenital anomaly, chromosomal anomalies, chances are very less. तो इसको देखना होगा. जो हमारे यहाँ कुंडली मिलान कहा गया है वो बड़ा इम्पोर्टेंट है. जो कुंडली मिला करते थे तो वो लोग हर तरीके से चीजें जानते थे कि कैसे गुण दोष मिलाना है. कभी शादी करते थे, तो अगर ऐसे अगर शादी की जा रही है तो उसी कारण वो सही होता था. देन सेकेंड देन ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी बाय फॉलोइंग द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ एंटीनेटल केयर व्हाट इज गर्भिणी परिचर्या एंड अवॉइडिंग द गर्भोपात का भाव, अगर ये करती हैं लेडीज तो दे आर बेस्ट, और अगर प्लानिंग ऑफ द प्रेगनेंसी तो दीज आर द बेस्ट टू प्रिवेंट इट. Strict restriction to the ladies and smoking, use of alcohol, radiation drugs at high potency. Basically, Indian culture में तो इतना नहीं है, but in metros we can get these things, smoking, alcoholism. But in most of the part of country, they are not present. But the radiation and drug exposure are still present in rural areas also. The drug can be easily means the medicine. For many diseases are present at the medical store and the ladies easily take that. During labor, educating regarding bearing down effort by avoiding the mool ghar cranial injuries, wo especially education and at the time of birth wo dena hoga. Usko prepare karna hota hai mother ko ki what is going to happen, aapko how to precipitate, kaise aapko aage pressure lagana hai, it should be there. When there is proper education और उसको अगर पूरा बता देते हैं तो इट्स वेरी इजी फॉर एनी लेडी टू गेट दिस. ड्यूरिंग न्यूनेटल पीरियड प्राण प्रत्यागमन मतलब जो रिसस्टिटेशन शुड बी प्रॉपर शुड बी प्रॉम्प्टली डन एंड शुड बी ऑन टाइम है ना, एंड द रक्षा कर्म एंड द फीडिंग एट द टाइम शुड बी देयर. टाइमली एंड स्किल्ड रिसस्टिटेशन ऑफ द न्यूबॉर्न लीड्स टू गुड आउटकम. प्रॉपर केयर ऑफ द अम्बिलिकल कॉर्ड एंड द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ टाइल पिचू, ये जहाँ पर लोग आज भी करते हैं और उसको कैसे आगे पोस्टनेटल केयर देनी है, शुड बी देन एट अ टाइम. एंड देन कम्स टू स्पेसिफिक मेजर व्हाट शुड बी डन एंड व्हाट वी डू है ना. व्हाट बीइंग द डोमिनेंट डोज इन्वॉल्व द ट्रीटमेंट प्लान शुड बी वात संशमन है ना. तो वात को ही मेनली हम लोग अपने दिमाग में रख के माइंड में रख के उस तरह का ही प्लान करते हैं कि क्या क्या ट्रीटमेंट मॉडलिटीज रखी जाए जो कि वात व्याधि को ठीक करती हैं. तो उसमें तो बेसिकली आता है वस्ति. मैनेजमेंट ऑफ वात इज स्नेहन स्वेदन एंड वस्ति एज द कंडीशन ऑफ धातु का क्षय मेनली मस्तुलुंग ट्रीटमेंट शुड बी बृहन चिकित्सा. तो एक तरफ तो हमें वस्ति और स्नेहन स्वेदन ये जो है इम्पोर्टेंटली करना ही है, लेकिन क्योंकि अगर जो मस्तुलुंग क्षय हो गया है जो ब्रेन डैमेज है तो उसके लिए बृहन चिकित्सा चिकित्सा करनी है. तो ब्रेन को बढ़ाने के लिए जो मेद रसायन है उस तरह के भी देने हैं. इन द डीरेंज स्टेट ऑफ जाथरणी और दंतग्नि एंड द इनवर्बल स्त्रोतो दस दीपन पाचन एंड अदर मेडिसिन शुड बी स्टार्टेड बिफोर द ब्रेन चिकित्सा, बिकॉज़ बेबी में जनरली जो अग्नि होती है वो मांद होती है, वो ठीक से खाने पीने में स्वलिंग एंड देयर आर मेनी डिफिकल्टीज आल्सो. तो ओरल मेडिकेशन गिविंग देना इज वेरी बिकम डिफिकल्ट समटाइम्स. Taking to the account of the age and the immature level of the doshas, dosh and agni of the patient, drug employed should be snigdha, mridu and the laku. मतलब इसी तरह की drugs को करना चाहिए जो importantly जो snigdha हो, mridu हो, madhur हो और आराम से बच्चा ले सके. नहीं तो otherwise when we give certain medication, many times the patient tells that the baby is not taking, it's very मतलब the baby start vomiting the when they are giving these drugs. As far as possible, shodhan therapy should be avoided, but vasti is a part of shodhan therapy which has been given. Other like vaman and vishan are generally strictly avoided in this type of babies. Snehan is more important while treating vastic disorders. जो हम लोग बाहर स्नेहन करते हैं, that become very important. हम with them. ड्रग्स लाइक महानारायण तेल, महाविषगर्भ तेल, ये सबको जब यूज करते हैं, महामाशादी तेल, तो स्नेहन उसमें बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट करता है. स्नेहन कैन बी एक्सटर्नल बाय एज वेल एज इंटरनल, द मोस्टली द विच विल डन इन केस ऑफ सीपी इज स्नेहन बाय बाय स्नेहन एक्सटर्नल मसाज. मसाज इज ऑफ द एंटायर बॉडी विद द मेडिकेटेड ऑयल लाइक महानारायण, महामाशादी एंड महासंधावादी ऑयल आज बीन यूजफुल. स्पेसिफाइड पंचकर्मा प्रोसीजर लाइक शिरोवस्ति, शिरोधारा आर एज वेल एज प्रोलॉन्ग कोर्स ऑफ वस्ति मेडिकेटेड एनिमा आर वेरी यूजफुल इन दिस ऑफ कंडीशन. एज आई टोल्ड वस्ति वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. वस्ति इज सेड टू बी द बेस्ट ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ वात रोग है ना. एज ऑल स्टूडेंट आप लोग सब जान रहे हो स्टूडेंट ऑफ आयुर्वेदा, कि वस्ती ऑलमोस्ट हाफ चिकित्सा, चलकने से आधी चिकित्सा बताइए, एंड वस्ती इज द बेस्ट पार्ट विच कैन बी गिवन टू बेबी ऑफ सीपी, है ना, क्योंकि उन लोग को ओरल मेडिकेशन देना इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट, मच ऑफ द मेडिसिन आर नॉट बीन एबल टू गिव, बट वेन वी एडमिट दिस काइंड ऑफ पेशेंट वी प्लान वस्ती इन दिस ऑफ चिल्ड्रेन फॉर 8-14 और अदर पीरियड्स एंड वी डू वस्ती रोगा वस्ती चिकित्सा रिस्ट्रिक्टेड टिल द चाइल्ड हैज अटेन्ड द क्रॉलिंग एज, बट इनवाशन वस्ती इज कंप्लीट फ्रॉम अर्ली इन्फेंसी. We start vasti at generally 1 year of age, almost the way crawling 9-10 month pe aati hai, and we also start vasti at after 1 year of age, with in which we can easily see the baby. Serous being the seat of particular disease, nasha has been a definite role in treatment. Pratimarsh nasha is given good result in children. We do in each and every children we also do nasha. Nurse to be planned for each and every baby. Even this can be given at OPD basis also, because nurse has been told as a sirsodwaram. So medicated oils or even some drugs can be given from this medicine, which act on majja dhatu, hai na, medh rasayan, are useful in the condition like guruji, amalki, musta, and other many drugs are ashwagandha, hai na, madhyasthi. And either many many other drugs which are being given. Useful rasayan, use of rasayan having made the intellect properties like Brahmi, Mandupanni, Sang Pushpi, Jyotishmati, Kuchman, Yashti Madhu, Ashwagandha, Shatavari, Guruji. Vacha remains one of the best medicine for this kind of baby. We used to give vacha in all our patients. Then Haritki, Abrak Bhasma, Swarna Bhasma. Nowadays, Swarna Prashan is one of the main entity, the main role has come for the CP patient also. I used to give Swarna Prashan in each and every patient on an even daily basis, not on monthly or not on weekly, but I used to give in daily basis Swarna Bhasma, in which the intellect property of the child who are basically mental retarded, they get very much benefit. So the mid property of the Swarna is very important. And the Yogendra Ras that also contain gold and many others, Khanjankari Ras, these are all been given. Some of these medication are also useful in preventing and reducing convulsions. You can get Mandupanni and Ashwagandha, they are also useful for preventing and reducing convulsion also. Other medication are used which improve nerve conduction, muscular coordination, Kashyap Gugulu, Yogaraj Gugulu. So these are many many drugs, Mandur Bhasma, which are being given, which also help in anemia and others. So these are what are the path and apath. We should tell all the children what are the path and apath. Then the food item having light, lukewarm and nutritional properties are suitable for this condition. Leaf greenery, vegetables, cereals, rice, wheat, sprouts, green, which are basically good for any other child, should be given to them also. And then apathya, avoid cold, putrefied, heavy foods, exposure of the hot and damp surroundings, or even the junk food should be avoided in each and every child. And this should be avoided in every child. So going towards the same case which was there. Okay, let's stop. You can see this slide.
Hello, sir.
So you can see this slide.
Yes, sir.
Diagnosis of spastic quadriplegia CP.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So again, coming to that child, which was 3 year old child, so we can know. I have told in the first slide, when we take history, they are unable to sit, unable to walk, unable to stand. Generally, we take history like this, na? And most of the when the UG or PG student, they write like this, ki chalta nahi hai, bolta nahi hai, as the parents are telling. But these are very painful. I have told that this is a very painful condition. A mother who is saying her or his baby is not able to hold his hand. She is not able to walk with him. So it's very difficult. एक माँ है जो कह रही है कि उसका बच्चा है जो बोल नहीं पा रहा है, वो सुनना चाहती है माँ, लेकिन उसका बच्चा नहीं बोल पा रहा है. एक बाप है, the father who is not able to hold his hand and he walks with his child. So it's a very difficult condition. I mean, a society when most of the children are normal, when the most of the children are happily with their parents, but this children, specific their children, become a very much liability on society and all on them also. So while taking history, any person should be very much specific and should be sensitive towards them. It is not like only writing history. So we must be very sensitive to these child, because many of the time they go to modern medicine and baba or any, they have been told ki yahan par acha ho jayega. They go to certain tantric or many other, they find ki kahin kuch ho jaye, and ultimately they come to us also, and they have lot of hope in their eyes ki kuch kahin par ho jaye. It's a very difficult disease to treat, because there are many modalities are present with them. It is not only the motor function which are involved, but the other also like speech defect, hearing defect, and other things, mental retardation is also present. So this baby, this kind of disease is very difficult to treat, and we can also not tell if we can treat them properly, but we can have sensitization towards them. You know, at least we can be sensitive towards them. We can not only treating, but what are the other things? क्या क्या उसके साथ हम और भी कर सकते हैं अदर देन ट्रीटमेंट? उसको और क्या क्या समझा सकते हैं कि उसके बच्चे को जो इंटैक्ट हो, जो फंक्शन इंटैक्ट हो. समटाइम्स इन केस ऑफ डायप्लेजिया व्हेन द लोअर लिम्स आर इन्वॉल्व, आई नो मेनी केसेस जो मेरे पास आते हैं बच्चे जो है डायप्लेजिया के, जहाँ के बच्चे चल नहीं पा रहे, खड़े नहीं पा रहे, बट दे हैव वेरी गुड हैंड प्रॉपर, मतलब उनके हैंड मूवमेंट ठीक है. तो आई यूज टू गिव देम पेन पेंसिल और इवन कलर्स, कि इसको सिखाइए कलरिंग सिखाइए, उसको पियानो दीजिए, उसको गिटार दीजिए, है ना. दे कैन हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ, मतलब उसमें ही अच्छा निकालिए, उसको गिटार बजाना सिखाइए, पियानो बजाना सिखाइए, उसको आर्ट दीजिए, ब्रश दीजिए, कलर दीजिए, सो दैट देयर मेंटल फंक्शन गेट और मोर एंड मोर गुड. सो इट इज नॉट ओनली गिविंग ड्रग, वी हैव टू बी थिंकिंग फ्रॉम अदर वेज ऑल्सो. So the diagnosis of that child, which was Divyansh, spastic quadriplegic cerebral palsy, and exact I have told these things. So management जो हम लोग यहाँ करते हैं, generally what I used to give ashwagandha adi chirpak, in which I used to give ashwagandha, shatavari, madhuyashti, bala, and gokshur. And these are in equal part, and mixing it water and milk, and then boiling it, making a chirpak, and giving it 10 or 20 ml BD. And a vacha chun, again if it for 25 mg, or even vacha mool is present, so directly vacha mool bhi ghis ke patthar pe, usko kate 10 to 40 times ghis ke, usko honey aur shahad ke saath de de, that also works very good. Brihatwar chintamani ras, it can be given in each child, child with cerebral palsy with their hypertonia. Kalyana grit, it works very good in case of children with seizure disorders. Massage with Mahanarayan tail, Bala tail, and I have told other tails also. Iron syrup, because there much time anemia is present. Snehan and Swedan, salicylic pin swed, we do when we admit the patient, we do salicylic pin swed, Upna swed. I will show you Afghan and Vasti. You can see this baby, we are giving Snehan, and Mahanarayan tail is sabse Snehan karte hain in our setups. And then it's salicylic pin swed. And these are been done. This is Upnas with, and generally हम लोग अगर रात को पूरे बच्चे को मतलब lay form में drugs बनाते हैं, many drugs been given, और फिर उसको पत्ता लपेट के, and then the covering with the clothes, and then this been done. तो इससे भी बहुत अच्छा Upnas with से we get, in case of hypertonia we get good results. अफगान जब हम लोग स्नेहन स्वेदन कर लेते हैं तो अफगान करा देते हैं बच्चों को दशमूल क्वाद से विद वाटर. वस्ती रिमेन्स अ मेन ट्रीटमेंट. तो व्हाट आई यूज्ड टू गिव वस्ती, जनरली जो नीरु वस्ती मैं देता हूँ यहाँ पर, एडमोस फ्रॉम 3 to 5 ml पर केजी से देता हूँ, और विद अनवासन वस्ती आई यूज्ड टू गिव 1 to 2 ml पर केजी से. for each child with KG, Hana. What I have discovered in my practice from last 5 to 8 years. तो दशमूल कुआत जो वस्ती के लिए जो नीरु वस्ती यूज करते हैं तो दशमूल कुआत महानारायण तेल यून बला तेल कन्यारंकृत अश्वगंधा आदि शी पाक हनी एंड सेंधव विद युक्ति प्रमाण एंड अदर द पंच प्रसिद्धिक और छह प्रसिद्धिक वस्ती विच इज बीन डिस्क्राइब इन आवर टेक्स्ट बट समटाइम्स वी मॉड्यूलेट विद आवर सेल्फ युक्ति प्रमाण लगा के उसको चेंज करके अपने हिसाब से मॉडिफाइड करके अकॉर्डिंग टू चाइल्ड यूज टू गिव एंड देन there are much improvement in cognitive function of child. When we give these made drugs, na, the most important thing what we get result in early after 2 to 3 months of treatment, most of the parents said the baby has become very much active. They have become the more active alertness बहुत आ गई है, वो पहचानने ज़्यादा लगा है, वो ज़्यादा interact करने लगा है. तो ये जो motor function, cognitive functions, तो most of the patient में if they get early आ जाते हैं तो मिलने लगता है. And the child become more active in form of interactive before. Memory बढ़ जाती है, patient बताते नहीं, they can, the memory है पहले से ज़्यादा better हुई है. और in case of CDC जो इस बच्चे में जो हम लोग को मिली थी, I have told earlier the red signs which was at the time of registration, and now after almost 6 months having two setups of 6 months of oral treatment with two setups of admission I have having vasti at 1 month apart jo hum log usko diye the uske baad usko jo head holds he can hold head steady from when moved around almost grading 0 se 4 aa gaya tha sitting mein can sit sitting straight aa gayi thi almost baithne laga tha with support and then standing mein sometimes he can stand with holding a furniture and TMFC में भी fine motor में almost try to reach hold things with good grip. अब उसकी जो gripping हो गई थी थोड़ी सी better पहले से हो गई थी. By slowly by night after 6 months he can speak mama baba with more or less time. And then personal and social में resist if toys pulled. मतलब इस तरह से मिल गया था. तो you can see now almost जब हम लोग ने इसको present किया था और ये बच्चा है वही जो दिव्यांश था स्टार्टिंग में तो नाउ ही कैन एबल टू सिट है ना हम लोग ने उसको बैठाया तो ही कैन सिट एट ऑलमोस्ट 1 to 2 मिनट्स लेकिन वो जब थोड़ा मूवमेंट करता है तो गिर भी जाता है आई कैन स्टैंड यू कैन सी तो लेट्स कम टुगेदर फॉर सेरेब्रल पाल्सी चिल्ड्रन एंड वेरी मच थैंक यू फॉर पेशेंट लिसनिंग इट्स अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट नॉट ओनली टॉपिक टू ट्रीट बट इट्स अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट डिजीज टू ट्रीट thank you very much for patience with me. If you have questions, please ask.
Hello, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir. Thank you, sir. It was very informative, sir. I request all the participants, if you have any queries, you can ask or you can put your queries in chat box.
Questions are always welcome. If you have any query, please do ask. No, we can have a discussion on this. Each of our student will become a future doctor, na?
Sir, one question is there, sir. How basti dravyas are chosen?
Okay. See, basti dravya generally what we given in our text and what we get those are those drugs which are vat shamak and medhi, है ना? जो vat shamak भी हो, medhi भी हो, है ना? They are been given priority like ashwagandha, shatavari, madhuyasthi. These are medhi and also vat shamak, है ना? तो वी हैव टू वात को शुद्धि भी करना है वात भी हटाना है प्लस देयर बीन गिवन प्रायोरिटी जस्ट लाइक बला है ना दीज आर ऑल बीन यूज्ड दे हैव बीन प्रूवन प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ नोनोट्रॉपिक्स दे आर ऑल मेड दे आल्सो एंड दे आर ऑल बीन गिवन इन केस ऑफ वात व्याधि सो दे हैव बीन चूजन फर्स्ट जस्ट लाइक वचा वचा हैज goal in case of meth. It is a good sign, and vacha has been given for oral medication. But it sometimes when we also give a little amount of vacha in vasti also, so it should be given.
Sir, one more query is there, sir. 3 years female baby has muscular weakness and
sit and for long time and
can't sit for long time. No any abnormalities.
See, first the most important thing is to taking history, hai na. Weakness can be from other muscular disorders also, hai na. Muscular atrophies are there like DMD and BMD and other muscular dystrophy. Even sometimes in case of deficiency of vitamin D, rickets, malnutrition, PM, which will all have weakness, hai na. Even in case of anemia, severe anemia will lead to this. But we have to take history, proper history. If there is a history of birth asphyxia or we will not present, but if there is history of prematurity or if it is LBW baby, if there is history of delayed milestones, if the 3 year baby with normal milestones and getting muscular weakness at 3 year, then it will be certainly not CP, cerebral palsy, but it can be a kind of muscular dystrophy, yes, which can be like DMD, which can be present at after 3, 4, 5 years of age.
Yes, sir. Sir, one more is there, sir. For involuntary movements of baby, what to prescribe? And those who are taking baclofen, sir.
See, baclofen is not been all.
And other than baclofen, is there any alternative in Ayurveda, sir?
Yes, sir. See, baclofen is generally given in hypertonic, hai na, hypertonia, and yes, not for involuntary movements also, hai na. But certain drugs when we give oral, jo cheat pak hai, jo shuganda jadi cheat pak hai na, if it has been given, it works very good in case of maintenance of tone of the baby, which is hypertonia also, hai na. Or especially for involuntary movements, we can get tagar, and I used to give tagar also in certain kids of baby, in which calmness and sang pushpi can be given, which has better role, and in case of involuntary movements also, and certain rasrajvati, which is made by certain combination of drugs which contain swarn, also help in this case of involuntary movements, and but to a certain limit, we cannot say ki properly, but to a certain limit it generally helps along with snehan.
Sir, one more, sir. Sir, is there any treatment plan for hypotonic and hypertonic cerebral palsy? Is there any different plans, or like we have to follow the same?
No, sir, they are very different plans. When we treat for hypotonia, hai na, and if hypertonia, generally bala and balras therapies, hai na. If there is hypotonia, hai na, I used to give bal when vasti has been planted, hai na, to bala oil, hai na, bala oil and gokshur, hai na, madhu yashti, these are prominently used, hai na. Bala oil, rather than having more use of maharan tail, the bala oil are mostly used, and the use of madhu yashti and a gokshur. Gokshur is very much good for muscle bulk, hai na. You can go for gokshur jo bal ke liye bataya gaya hai, to gokshur ka use agar kiya jaye, even in cheer pak also works very good. So amount should be increased of this for gokshur and madhu yashti.
Okay, sir, thank you, sir.
Of the baby is taken from major hospital, no one or two taking and demonstrating of medicine and diagnosed only strengthening medicine.
So I think there was a question, sir. Only milestone delayed, and I'm giving treatment salicylic acid this way. Basti getting good result, and can you suggest internal medication? Sir, there's GDD is global developmental delay. It's a broad term, and even for CP and many other disorders, GDD and a global developmental delay. So if there is a delay in milestones, so first we have to think if it is from fine motor, gross motor, language, personal, which motor milestone. If it is misleading, it's a motor milestone. So if it is fine or gross motor milestone, so Sneha and Shwedan should be on a priority on not only on OPD, IPD basis, but we have to tell patient to daily basis or twice or once they have to do 10 to 15 minutes of Sneha at home also. This should be done in case of hypertonia. We can use Mahamashadi Tel, Mahanayak Tel combination, which can be used and we get good result in that patient. उसको अगर लगातार अगर यूज करते हैं तो टिल वी डू मसाज वी गेट गुड रिजल्ट बट एज लॉन्ग एज वी व्हेन वी लेफ्ट दिस काइंड ऑफ पेशेंट आफ्टर 2 to 3 मंथ दे सडनली गेट द बैक एट द सेम लेवल है ना तो इफ वी डू रेगुलर मसाज इन दैट पेशेंट सो द कॉन्ट्रेक्चर्स शुड नॉट बी मेड वंस द कॉन्ट्रेक्चर्स आर मेड है ना दैट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू ट्रीट सो इफ वी डू अ रेगुलर मसाज एंड and properly salis cystic pain dissuade so the contractures and the gross motor milestones get better and internal medication what I am telling ki internal medication mein for med ke liye for med purpose for mental retardation I used to give swarnaprashan and you can go swarnaprashan what we get in your areas so swarn works very good for med purpose it's very an excellent medicine and swarnaprashan ke upar pura ek seminar ho sakta hai we are talking on swarnaprashan in this corona kind era there so much need of swarnaprashan even that so not only for immunity purpose but it is one of the best medicine for medh also so when we used swarnaprashan for medh for medh person in cp patient it works internally very good along with that swarn has many role hai na So it works good for that also. Another medication which can also be used.
Sir, one more question is this regarding nausea, sir.
Okay.
Can you guide about nausea in these conditions?
See, basic जो प्रतिमश नष्ट है जो what can give is जो हम लोग अणु तेल से नष्ट एक तो basic कर सकते हैं लेकिन इन अणु तेल है ना क्योंकि अणु तेल सिर्फ है जो अणु तेल हमारे पास है उसमें अगर हम लोग मेध रसायन है ना देयर सर्टेन ड्रॉप्स ऑफ केरला आयुर्वेद वी गेट है ना लाइक ब्राह्मी है ना तो अगर ब्राह्मी का काढ़ा बना के और उसमें क्वाथ बना के ब्राह्मी मंडूक पर्णी एंड अलोंग विद अश्वगंधा जब उसको बना के और अणु तेल से मिला के फिर वन ड्रॉप बीडी दे सकते हैं तो क्योंकि उसको माना जाता है कि इट्स वन ऑफ द बेस्ट मेध रसायन ब्राह्मी works very good for that to brahmi ke kwat kaade ko bana ke kwat bana ke with anunas we can go through this
yes sir thank you sir sir one more query sir
yes sir
sir most of the time in cerebral palsy like whether it is mild to moderate cases in case of mild to moderate cerebral palsy most of the time the even though upper limbs are spared sir
yes like, sir
or whether it may be hemiplegic or diplegic yes, in these case I have seen few cases like in that the even though the IQ is little bit okay up to 75% or 65 to 75% of IQ. In that also like the some slurred speech and speech difficulties I am finding sir like for that like how
muk lep, sir we can go for muk lep what I used to give muk lep for that children in case of slurred speech in for many cause there swasthata I am taking the name swasthata granules come from some cortical ayurveda these come from or even from kerala ayurveda or even you can meet by many of the meat rasayan vacha basically which have more vacha so with shahad mukh lep in the soft and hard palate then the side and the if we can go for this muklip to these kind of children for 3 months, you know, almost for 3 months, then we get a good result in case of slurred speech, but not in case for CP patient, but in case of slurred speech for certain patient who are coming for slurred speech or not able to speak properly, if we give muklip to the of this bacha and this swachhata can use, then we get good result after 2 to 3 months.
Sir, we are using Saraswata Churna, sir. Saraswata Churna.
Yes, Saraswata Churna is very good for memory also.
Haan, sir.
Sir, I want to say one thing. Many of the patients, many times they come. I can tell you one story. A 9-year-old boy, comes to me with his father. He was not able to speak. Hai na?
Yes, sir.
He was not able to speak and he has severe sensorineural hearing loss, SNEL, na? And the father is roaming from many, many departments, from ENT, from modern medicine, even from AIMS. And he comes to Ayurveda OPD, there is certain medication so that he get benefited. After seeing all his papers, I know ki no medicine or no hearing aid will affect. तो आई टोल्ड हिम कि सर इसका पैर ठीक है, वो बच्चा एकदम ठीक था, सिर्फ सुनता नहीं था, उसका पैर ठीक था, हम क्या इसको दौड़ाओ, इसको एथलीट
यस सर
ना बोलेगा ना, वो ऑल ओवर वर्ल्ड जाएगा, आप उस चीज पे मत, हम लोग उस चीज के पीछे पड़ते हैं, जैसे हमारे वही है ना फेयर लवली का आइडिया, काले हैं तो उसको सबको गोरा होना है ना, तो जो हमारे पास नहीं है तो उसके पीछे हम ज्यादा पड़ते हैं, लेकिन अगर हमारे पास फंक्शन इंटैक्ट है, कोई बच्चा डायप्लेजिया है, जो लोअर लिम इन्वॉल्व्ड है, एज यू टोल्ड, he can do brushing. मैं अपने हाथ से बच्चों को जब होता है तो देता हूँ उसको ब्रशिंग, देता हूँ कलर, देता हूँ, एटलीस्ट वो बच्चा उस चीज में इन्वॉल्व हो, है ना?
Yes sir. Sir, one more my clinical experience, sir. During our while internal medication or OPD level treatment of cerebral palsy,
yes,
like most of the time the parents are not that much convenient to take the child for the frequent panchakarma procedures, and
yes,
depending on depending yes, on the all the procedures, like if you are admitting the child it will be very good, but the most of the time it is not that much convenient, sir.
Yes, sir.
That's why like how you are planning the panchakarma procedures with proper intervals, like what intervals or how much time gap you are giving between the two sessions of
between two session, at least sir, we must have 1 to 2 months, matlab at least 2 month of gap should be there, hai na? Huh. In each when we do vasti in patient, what I clinically do from almost as a 5-6 year of practice, or even I was a SR, so at least 2 months of gap should be there maintained, and a oral medication should be continued. But if we are doing vasti, and a of 8 or 14 days, generally yoga or karma vasti, but we are planning. So at least 2 months of gap is there, then it will be good. Otherwise, if we go on vasti at very frequent interval, we may can damage our tone or something can happen.
And also, sir, along with the patients of cerebral palsy, those who are coming to Ayurvedic coming for Ayurvedic treatment,
yes, and sir,
they are already associated with seizure disorders,
yes,
and
sir,
they have already taking some anti epileptic drugs, sir. Hello, sir.
Sir, I'm not getting. 1 minute, sir.
बोलिए सर.
हेलो सर.
यस सर, बोलिए सर.
सर ऑडिबल सर.
यस सर.
हाँ सर, दी पेशेंट्स दोज हु आर टेकिंग आर कमिंग फॉर आयुर्वेदिक ट्रीटमेंट फॉर सेरेब्रल पैल्सी और लाइक मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम एसोसिएटेड कोमॉर्बिड कंडीशन दैट इज द एपिलेप्सी.
यस सर.
और सीजर डिसऑर्डर्स एसोसिएटेड विद सीजर डिसऑर्डर्स.
यस सर.
इवन आई एम ट्रीटिंग सच पेशेंट्स.
यस
सर. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम they are on anti epileptic drugs, sir.
Yes, sir.
And those because of that they will be like drowsy like that, sir. Some.
Yes, sir.
Huh, sir. Like along with that, the how to wean that those drugs.
Sir, as I have told, most of the time, within more than 50%, they have associated with seizure disorders, na. So yes, they are taking long time anticonvulsant drugs like phenobarbital, levera, phenytoin, and valproate, na. So first, we have to see the what is the EEG status, na. If it has been done. Before 3 months or 6 months, sometimes they are taking from a long time and long time and long time, and there is no seizure, you know.
Yes, sir.
So we can have a EEG, and then we can taper it, and then after 3 months we have again EEG, then we can stop tapering, you know. But if there is problem in EEG and the patient is telling if there is continuously seizure are present on and off once a week or once a month. So firstly, we have to do a proper dosing. Hai na? Sometimes they have shown to a certain neurologist or certain pediatrician, jo dose 2.5 ml chal raha hai, wo saal bhar pehle se chal raha hai, and they have increased the weight. Hai na? To pata chala uski proper dosing nahi hui hai. To pehle to dose proper karna hai. Because these, as certain things like this, if they have TB, so we have to give anti-tubular clot drug. We can have adjacent drug also, but we cannot say ki abhi TB ki drug rok ke abhi ye dena hai. Usi tarah we don't have some certain medicine. We can say we can actually stop and seizure, hai na, in the proper manner, hai na. We can have certain drugs which can have adjacent, like when we give Mahakalyanakrit or Kalyanakrit, hai na, along with that certain medication which stop or decreases the frequency of seizures. है ना, तो वो जब देंगे तो कम होते जाता है, कम होते जाता है, लेकिन वी कैन वी नीड बट विथ प्रॉपर ईजी रिकॉर्डिंग. हमें पास ईजी मॉनिटरिंग होनी चाहिए. ऐसा नहीं कि अगर पता चला हम लोग ने रोक दिया और सडनली जब रिफ्रैक्टरी सीजर हो जाता है, देन इट बिकम वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू ट्रीट, है ना. तो व्हेन वी हैव ईजी आफ्टर हैविंग 3 months एंड इफ वी हैव नो एपिलेप्सिक एपिसोड और जेनाइट्स और एनी डिफॉर्मिटी इन दैट, then we can stop by weaning one by one if it is going on two or three or even one drugs.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Are you okay? Thank you,
sir. I think all the queries over, sir. I think
okay. Yes. We have long talked on this, and cerebral palsy remains the universal. When I was in Belgaum last month, I have told you Pallav. Then I've also suggested there should be multi-central trial in ILAP. I've told Aziz Abbar and all the dignitaries present there, even the Shalja ma'am and the sir from Tamil Nadu, I don't remember the name, we should have, just like in modern medicine, they have multi-central trial. We should also have a multi-central trial. The drug which been used in Tamil Nadu, in Kerala, in Karnataka, in Gujarat, in BHU, we can have certain group of disease hyper and certain medicine which should be given to all over India, so that we can get a disease. So you are also treating cerebral palsy by your own. I am also treating, and other madam or sir also, Krishnaiah sir, I think Krishnaiah,
yes, sir, yes,
hai na, he is also famous for CPS, hai na. So what they are doing and what we are doing, sometimes when I visiting Belgaum, they are giving Basti from age, hai na, they give 2 to 3 ml by per age, hai na,
yes, sir,
as
yes.
I am giving kg, hai na, I am giving from almost, I can give almost 50 to 60 ml of Niru Basti in certain patient, hai na, and after that most of the time wo jo 10-12 kg ke bacche hote hain usse zyada dene par wo expel out kar dete hain, turant aa jata hai. So I found ki 3 to 5 ml per kg se dene se abhi theek hai. Or 1 to 2 ml per kg se anuvasan vasti. What I have been clinically getting in my setup. So if we have a multi-central trial for this type of patient, then it will be more benefit rather than doing this.
Yes, sir. Yes. Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. It was a very informative session, sir. And sir shared their knowledge and clinical experience on the topic cerebral palsy. I would like to thank sir for their wonderful presentation in this regard, and also for their sharing their clinical experience. And also I would like to thank all the participants for their patient listening and being the part of lecture 1 Kumaravarana 2020. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Tomorrow
thank you,
at
thank you all the organizers.
Sir, tomorrow at 11:30 we have lecture 2 of Kumaravarana 2020 by Dr. Ved Prakash Vyas, sir, professor, Department of Komarabhutya, Government Dhanvantari Ayurveda Medical College, Ujjain, MP, on the topic Panchakarma procedures in children. And I expect all of you to participate for the tomorrow session. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, and thank you one and all.
Thank you.
Patient listening. Thank you, sir. Thank you.